Hello. Let's see if anybody's out there. It's Wellness Wednesday time. Come into the room. Today, I'm actually doing this on my professional page. So I'm hoping that everybody comes over from the personal page to the professional page to check this out. I'm going to give you guys a few minutes to get into a room and the room, and then we're gonna get started. Oh, I see that someone's here. Say something so I can see who you are. I can just tell that someone's here, but I don't see anything. If you type something, hey, Dr. Michelle, how are you? Thanks for joining today. And if you know anybody else that can benefit from this information, please invite them. You know, send them a text or a message telling them to get on. So now that I have at least one person on today, yay, we're going to go on and get started. And hopefully some more people will join us. I'm going to go on and introduce myself for those who come on later or see this later on who may not know me. I am Dr. Pam Middleton, your virtual holistic pediatrician. I help families achieve and maintain health through inside-out healing, and that is using holistic methods, mind, body, and spirit, for your total healing. Hi, Ellie, how are you, Ellie? I'm glad that you joined us today. Okay, and so we're going to get started with the jars. So what happened with the jars, back in October of 2016, I decided to do an experiment, and I went out and bought a McDonald's Happy Meal, and I got hamburger French fries, and I put those into the a mason jar. And then I got a banana, and I took the apples from the Happy Meal and I put those in another mason jar to use as a control. So now I guess I'm being like the mad scientist. And every month I look at the mason jars to see how everything is breaking down. And so now, let's see, that was October. So we're several months in now. So let's see what has happened since October of 2016. Let's first of all look at the banana and the apple slices. So here we go. This is what it looks like now. This is our banana and our apple slices. So as you can see, there's a lot of liquid here. It looks a bit disgusting, but that's what we expect. I mean, it's been since October. You would expect that it's totally breaking down, and the only reason that it's still probably standing up is because of the bag of apples, which have expanded, and it's kind of holding the bananas up. Now, the apple slices themselves, they no longer look like apple slices either. They kind of look like tangerines now, like tangerine slices or orange slices. So this is, even though it's kind of gross and disgusting, but this is what we would expect food to look like that's been sitting around since October. Okay, so now let's move to our hamburger and French fries. So here we go. Here we see our French fries, our hamburger. It actually doesn't look very bad. If you see on the bottom, and I'll put it close, because the little spots you see, it's in the glass itself. There's nothing going on with this hamburger. It looks totally normal. Like you can just heat it up and eat it, okay? And so the hamburger looks fine. The bread looks fine. It's not molded. Nothing's breaking down. The French fries don't look as golden as they did before, but they're not really breaking down. You know, you would expect them now to just look a little bit more like this, and they're not. So let's talk about what's happening with fast food and what's happening when you or your children are eating these foods. Hi, Gabrielle. Thanks for joining us today. So what's going on is that, you know, obviously our body has hydrochloric acid that can break this down. But look at how hard our body's going to have to work. If this can sit in this jar looking like this for months, think of what our bodies have to go through to break stuff down. We don't want to work our bodies too hard. So what do you do? And I mean, I'm sure somebody's going to say, but I love McDonald's. I have to have my McDonald's. So maybe that's something that you just want to eat in moderation. Because what happens if you're eating stuff like this almost every day or a few times a week? And I know that it's happening because, you know, everybody's busy now. People want to eat quickly. They want fast food. And when I say fast food, they just want it fast. Like, you know, even at home, you want your food to be ready fast because nobody really has time for anything. So let's talk about five things that you can do, you know, five healthier fast food options. So number one, let's say that you are going to a fast food restaurant. You can actually make healthier choices in that restaurant. So let's say instead of getting the hamburger, the French fries, and the soda that comes in the combo, maybe you just get the hamburger and a side salad with water, okay? One thing. Second thing, maybe, you know, maybe you do get your French fries and your hamburger, but instead of getting that gigantic soda that you can get 50 refills of, you know, you might want to just have some water. Or if you do, you know, if you want to go with the special meal deal that they give you and get a drink, get unsweetened tea. Okay, so that way you can feel like, okay, well, you know, I didn't just go in there and get this little cup of water. But that's another option that you can do. So you can go in, you can change up, instead of the hamburger and French fries, you can replace that with, say, a salad. Instead of getting the really sweet drink, you can replace that with either water or, you know, get tea. If you want to get tea, you can get tea. Now, let's talk about the salads. Because sometimes we know that we can go into a fast food restaurant and get a salad that actually ends up having more calories than our hamburger, okay? So what you want to be careful of with the salad is your dressing. So the dressing that comes with the salads, they're processed. I mean, you know, once again, they're sitting around. So be careful with your dressing. I'm not telling you not to use the dressing, but use it sparingly. Don't just automatically empty out the whole pack. Try to use as little as possible with your salad. And if you're having, say, your salad with your hamburger, you know, kind of use your hamburger to offset not having so much dressing on your salad. All right. Now, other options. So that's kind of three things right there within the fast food restaurant. Another option is to go to maybe a healthier fast food restaurant, something like Subway, where you're going to get a healthier sandwich, or something like Chipotle, where you can get healthier foods. And at Chipotle, you can even get a lot of times organic meats. So that's like a fourth choice for you. And your fifth choice is actually if you're out and about and you're just like, I need something to eat, I need something to tide me over, go to the grocery store. You can actually go in the grocery store and get some healthy things that will get you, they'll keep you tied over until you get home. You can go to the grocery store and buy fruit and nuts. You know, you can just have that in the car. Okay, so you can go to the grocery store and get healthier food options too. And a lot of the grocery stores now will actually, they will even carry like salads. You can get salads there, prepared salads. Or if you have the grocery stores with the deli, you can go there and make a healthier deli choice. Like maybe you go to the deli and get baked chicken and a salad. So there are a lot of options that you have that can be healthier. And just, you know, if you think about these options beforehand, because, you know, when you're out and about and you're hungry and you see whatever fast food restaurant, you're just going to go. But if you've kind of thought about these things beforehand, then you may remember that, oh yeah, I can make a healthier choice. Maybe I'll just run by the grocery store and get such and such. Or maybe, you know, let me see if there's a Subway around or a Chipotle. So those are all things that you can do. Okay, so I hope that this helped. And for those of you who came on a little bit later, let me just show my experiment one more time. So remember, this was back in October, several months ago. This is my little McDonald's experiment. So this is what your McDonald's Happy Meal looks like after, what is it, October? It's like 7-8 months or 9 months. This is 9 months. This is what it will look like. You have your hamburger and your French fries. And they really have not changed. And then this is what real food looks like a banana or an apple. It actually starts to break down. And this is what we want. So this is why, as much as possible, we want to eat real foods, real live whole foods that will just break down on their own. Okay? So that's all for today. Remember, I am Dr. Pam Middleton, your virtual holistic pediatrician. Continue to follow me here on Facebook. Invite your friends to join me. I'm here every Wednesday for Wellness Wednesday around 12:15. And so come on, invite others back with you, and looking forward to seeing you next week. Bye-bye.